Lars Alexanderson, before I go any further, I'm letting you know now, though this guide is unbiased, Lars is that guy. He is the main character I play. I dig the hair, the lightning, the anime aesthetic. This is the homie. Anyway, referred to as the Jack of No Trades, this character is his own thing. Built-in evasion and advancement toward his opponent. But the heart of this character is punishment, damage, and wall carry. However, this is the Good String series, where over hundreds of moves in Tekken, we highlight good strings for a character to use as a starter pack or to help add something to your game. I am Empire Endless, your humble host, maker of the things, and voice of the words throughout this guide. And today, we'll be focusing on some really good strings for Lars Alexanderson, who though is a blast to play and can live that YOLO life, known in the community for being a risk taker, live by the sword, die by the sword, he does in fact have good strings. Strings that can cover up some of his flaws and even make a few of them completely disappear. Now let's have a closer look at Android Kikaider Lars. Begin. Let's start with Delta Slicer. Listed as number 4 in his move list, you will find Lars is user friendly with the complicated input 1-1-1. Though the full string knocks down on hit, we want to initially pay attention to the first two attacks. The one button by itself is a standard 10 frames, plus 8 on hit, a simple and clean incentive to keep your offense going. Now going over a little fundamental of Tekken here. In Tekken, a one jab is actually plus 1 on block. The game is rewarding you for your offense and prompts your opponent to duck as attempting to punch back gets them punched in the face. The second attack of Delta Slicer is neutral on hit, baiting your opponent to press. But if you keep the string going, mollywop, knockdown. The second attack is minus 8 on block. Safe. But if your opponent thinks you've stopped the string and goes to take their turn, again, mollywop, knockdown. Lars is like that. He is a conditional character. By that, I mean the longer the set goes on, the more mind games Lars can play, and the stronger he becomes. One of the key things that makes the first two hits of Delta Slicer so great is that it is high mid. So even if your opponent ducks the first hit, it is probable that they will be hit by the following mid. Maybe. You may end up trading with their Wild Rising move or Junk Punch, which isn't that bad considering that in this game, you throw out a high and your opponent ducks it, chances are you're going to get launched. Delta Slicer works best as a guaranteed counter hit string. You see your opponent has thrown out some sort of attack, and you interrupt it with Delta Slicer on counter hit. This string is good at the wall as well, as it wall splats. Also good to fish for after throwing out a move that Lars is plus on block, or has placed your opponent in crack. They go to press, and they ride the lightning. Full Delta Slicer is minus 14 on block. Not so safe. And a few characters in the game can even launch you for this. So the warning is this. Use the first two hits to condition your opponent. Lull them to sleep about the third hit by not throwing it out. And if you see them start to press buttons immediately after the second hit, perhaps it's time to go for the third one. I recommend using this pretty much as a counter hit strike. Or at the end of the match, when you feel your opponent becoming antsy, and you got a good feeling that they'll press. Next is Lightning Assault Middle. 213, number 7 on the move list. Let's look specifically at the first two hits. 2-1 starts at 10 frames and is +6 on hit. Excuse me, this is where I'm just gonna have to splice this in right here. Because these next two moves can act as replacement for a litany of other attacks on the Lars move list. Back 4, Magnetic Knee at number 53, and back 1, Chevron Slash, number 48. Both of these are supplemental moves, key to Lars' offense. It can be thrown out in between strings in an attempt to keep your opponent on lockdown or off guard, like the second hit of Lightning Assault. +6 on hit. This is a great placement for Magnetic Knee or Chevron Slash. And don't worry, I will refer to these moves when appropriate throughout this guide. Now, the full string of Lightning Assault Middle grants a knockdown and is a counter hit launcher if, let's say, your opponent blocks the first two hits and attempts to attack. The second punch is also -5 on block, right on that edge of being able to sidestep an opponent's linear attack and punch. The full string of Lightning Assault Middle is -12 on block, not so safe. And the kick is steppable to your opponent's left shoulder. This is when you mix with Lightning Assault High, 214, which knocks down on hit and is -7 on block. Safe. Because of the fact that Lightning Assault begins with the high mid, it is another one of Lars' moves that if your opponent ducks the first hit in attempts to do a Wild Rising move or Junk Punch, they may very well be counter-hit. It all depends on how fast they react to your movements, as you may be punished yourself. But the first two hits of Lightning Assault jails your opponent, whether on hit or on block. So if your opponent tries to sidestep the middle kick and you throw out the high, they will get smacked in the face. And if you do not want to take that risk of being -12 on the middle kick being blocked and punished, or the high being ducked and punished, Magnetic Knee. Back 4, 15 frames is a good option. +8 on hit, and the bastard son of Heihachi straight up chokes a dude on counter hit for great damage. Back 1, Chevron Slash is a 15 frame homing sidestep stopper. +4 on hit, and knocks down on counter hit. So you think they'll press after the first two hits of Lightning Assault? Magnetic Knee. They blocked the first two hits of Lightning Assault, and you think that they'll step? Chevron Slash. Magnetic Knee is -8 on block. Chevron Slash is -9. Lightning Assault High. Lightning Assault Middle. Lars does not have a Lightning Assault Low. He is his father's son. They struggle with that. But this is where you can begin to get very creative. This is where this move comes in. Number 42 in the move set, Arc Combination. Down back, 1-3. This may very well be Lars' best poke And if not, in my opinion, it's definitely his best low poke. This move will be extraordinarily annoying to your opponent. 17 frames startup low is not so bad. And if you land a low, the second hit, the kick, is guaranteed. And you immediately want to press down after inputting this move. So Lars will be plus one. You can back up after this, or go for a wild rising four if you think your opponent will challenge with a move higher than 11 frames. As an 11 frame move, let's just say one jab will trade with your wild rising four. Let's take a look so far at all of this strung together. No pun intended. Lightning assault. Magnetic knee. Chevron slash. Arc combination. All predicated on the threat of your turn not being over. That is what makes this entire mix-up work. Arc combination is minus 12 on block. Not so bad, but of course, it could also be parried. And the second hit is a high, so this move can be ducked and launched. So if you spam this move out, your opponent may very well catch on and make you pay. In tandem with all the aforementioned moves, our combination will avoid high attacks, so starting a string with Lars and then stopping in the middle with your opponent expecting you to finish the string, you instead throw out our combination. You don't have great plus frames after this, but again, this move is meant to be annoying as hell. Moving through the lightning, we have up next, double tap, down back 2-1, number 44 in the move list. You know, for a character that's supposedly a good guy, they give my man Lars some very viciously named moves. Anyway, double tap is an advancing mid-mid string starting at 15 frames. Plus 6 on hit. Once again, magnetic knee, or Chevron slash are really good options here. Chevron slash more so, as your opponent does have time to sidestep to their right to avoid the knee. But if they attempt to press a button after being hit, lightning strikes. That's the reiteration of these two moves. You think they'll press? Magnetic knee, and they get choked out. You think they'll step? Slash it with Chevron slash. Double tap is steppable left and right. Lars has an issue with his moves being steppable. But this move being stepped will more than likely occur if you simply spam it out. Be careful of when you place this move out because of that. This is one of Lars' space closers. It is only minus 8 on block. Safe. Your opponent throwing out a move and whiffing when your opponent attacks.
Nice G-Clef cannon.
He's getting a lot of jabs.
Gonna be just shy of rage right now. There it is, back 4. Big challenge. Rage available. 20 seconds left.
That didn't hit.
Okay, let's be honest. Mob, even you have to be honest, that didn't touch.
Yeah, that's why it hit.
What probably happened there is Bumby probably pushed the button. And when you push a button in second, it extends your hurt box. Yep. So things that look like they shouldn't hit, they hit. That's probably what happened now.
Yes, that's exactly right. It extends their hitbox. Your opponent throwing out a move and whiffing When your opponent attacks and it extends their hitbox, double tap is the perfect move to interrupt. And at that point, be standing in your opponent's face at plus 6 frames. This move, much like the theater of life, it's all about timing and space. And despite its step ability, I think it's one of Lar's best strengths. I wanted to include a punish move, because one of the key things that Lars excels at is that he has a great move set to punish opponents who choose to not play so safe. This move will never let you down in that regard. Death Mask, number 31 in the set. 424. Again, the names they give to these moves, man. Don't be surprised if in Tekken 8, Lars turns into a villain. This move is another labbing moment in Tekken. What characters you keep coming across that are attempting to get away with murder by throwing out a bunch of stuff that you have no idea the frames for? Learn these frames. Deathmaster, of course, starts off at 12 frames, has really good damage, and knocks down for great Oki settings. Never just throw this move out. It is not what it is for. Do not ever, and I mean never, try to randomly reach out and touch your opponent with this move. I will make sure your copy of Tekken 8 gets delayed indefinitely. Never throw this move out just to see if your opponent will press, or to reach out and catch your opponent off guard. At minus 12 on block, you will be punished in kind for throwing this move out haphazardly. Use Death Mask and Exclusivity as a 12 frame punisher or round ender for a move that is minus 12 frames or more on block. It's minus 12, smack him with the Mask of Death, and it also wall splats. This is a clean, simple move that is a staple in the Lars offense. Lars, like I said before, is his own thing. There are some things that he can't do so well, and there are a few things that he can do that very few other characters can. Like move number 52, Impulse Plus. Back 3-4 is one such move. This bad boy reaches out into the darkness for your opponent. It may not hit across the screen, but if the first kick hits, which is a mid by the way, the following kick is guaranteed for good damage and knockdown. An Impulse Plus is minus 8 on block. Save. These kicks are fresh, these kicks are clean, these kicks are mid-high. If the first kick is blocked at minus 12 and you go for the high, your opponent can duck and launch you. Also, Impulse Plus starts off at 17 frames. Not the fastest startup. The mid-kick is steppable, though oddly enough, the high will reach out and touch your opponent, whether they step left or right. However, you still can be counter-hit before your high kick reaches your opponent. Definitely want to use this one out in space against an opponent pressing buttons from afar. In to bait out a whiff from your opponent. You may be tempted to use Lightning Screw, but if you misjudge the distance and you whiff, your booty is out in the wind with no place to go. Better to use Impulse Plus if you're not so certain of the spacing. And to zoom in just a little more on the special ability of this move, is that you can punish things like Paul's Death Fist even at tip range. in Asuka's back three. So be sure to test this move out in the lab against moves that are minus 17 or more on block with a lot of pushback. Cause your boy may very well be able to deliver a couple of kicks to someone's face for their trouble. Lastly, let's go over Lars' longest string in his move list, aside from his 10-hit combo. Volcanic Lightning. Not at all a bombastic name, not at all. Number 32 on the move list. Forward 4-1-2-1. This is the make you guess when it's your turn move for Lars. I love strings like this. Four hits, all mid attacks. Let's break this down blow by blow. Forward 4 is plus 7 on hit, minus 9 on block. Same. Forward 4-1 is plus 2 on hit and also minus 9 on block. Anything beyond these two attacks becomes increasingly more unsafe. Forward 4-1-2 is also plus 2 on hit and minus 10 on block. Not so safe. Forward 4-1-2-1 knocks your opponent down, where you can do dynamic entry if you dare to get right up in their face, and is minus 14 on block. Be careful when using this move as a mind game against your opponent. Remember, anything beyond the first two hits is punishable. And believe it or not, the initial knee is steppable left and right, which in this case makes the whole thing steppable. You can just watch Lars go crazy across the screen throwing out this whole damn move. This whole string does jail your opponent. They cannot interrupt, they cannot sidestep in between hits, they just get to stand there. I recommend using the first two hits as a see what they do kind of test. Again, it may just be my opinion, but I think the longer the set goes on, the stronger Lars becomes because of the mind gaming and conditioning of your opponent. This is more feel than anything else. But if you start to notice them pressing buttons immediately after the first two hits, start to throw out the third one, and then the fourth one. The last hit of the string also wall splats, and this move can make it difficult for your opponent to get off the ground at the wall as well. Lots of flair, lots of lightning. The king of cool. The flaws of Lars lie in his lack of lows, in his ability therefore to open up his opponent. Use what you've learned today, coupled with the fact that he is a good whiff punisher and creative character, to mask the risk he takes and to optimize his strengths. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and keep in tune with the rhythm of the fight. Because a good string is like a good song. No matter how many times you repeat it, it's just as good as it was the first time. Wake up, get up, stretch my legs, eat some breakfast, milk and eggs, brush my teeth up, wash my face, throw my clothes on, start my day. Wake up, I can smell the smoke from the bacon. Let's go. See the sun shining from the window.